Check the headings here with the Vazen 85mm, which also yells, Vazen goes full frame and beyond! We'll get to that. Vazen is a fairly new company and, along with Siri, seems to be the only ones making new anamorphic lenses for a budget-limited market. Their initial offerings, the 28 and 40 mm, only supported micro 4 thirds, but this 85 mm aims at a different target audience. I've had this lens for longer than usual. I got it through Vazen to experiment, and I'm sending it back because I can't afford it. I loved it using it though. I used it throughout my feature shoot on both the Panasonic's GH5 and S5. It's a lens that's very easy to use on the field, and it's lightweight enough to not maim my shoulders when going handheld, especially comparing it with the rehoused Lomo Beasts. The Vazen 85 offers the same 1.8x squeeze, aiming to maximize the use of a 4x3 sensor for a perfect 2.4:1 aspect ratio without any crop. This squeeze also means you get a 47mm horizontal field of view when using this lens. The lens body feels solid, made of aluminum. It weighs 1.5 kilograms or 3.3 pounds. It isn't light, but in comparison, it's almost half of what an Atlas lens weighs. The lens measures 17.5 centimeters or 6.9 inches, and that's pretty long. This is Vazen's 85 side by side with a DIY rig of similar capabilities. Contax 85, Schneider Cinelux, and Rapido FED 35A. The DIY rig is considerably longer and it weighs almost twice as the Vazen. Focus comes down to 1.15 meters, but all the markings here are in feet. Here I have a bit of a qualm. Close focus reads 3.8 feet, but no one measures feet with decimal cases. It's always feet and inches. 3.8 feet translates as 3 foot 10. It's never a huge difference, but many first ACs will be tricked by this. A first AC pointed this out for me. I might not have noticed it otherwise. To fix the issue, I'd say switch to meters or do feet and inches, but not fractions of feet. Rant over. Focus throw is about 180 degrees and it makes a swooshing sound. You can watch Duclos' live analysis for more experienced info on this lens's construction. Iris is marked in T-stops going from 2.8 to 16. It has 12 aperture blades and aperture remains pretty circular throughout the range. Both focus and iris rings are geared for motors. The front has an outer diameter of 95mm. Which is compatible with lots of cine accessories, and the further threads are 86mm. The lens has an interchangeable EF and PL mount, and it comes with a couple shims so you can adjust back focus, and Vazen claims it can cover full frame open gate. This lens is also to be part of a set with a 55 and 105mm coming out in 2020 and 2021. I hope Vazen has been listening to feedback regarding standardizing focus methods, gear placement, lens size, focus scales, and everything else that should match on a proper cine lens set. Those were some of my issues between the 28 and the 40mm, which also don't match this lens. Now price. The Vazen 85 costs $8,000. This is the part where everyone picks up their pitchforks.
Ha! Very funny! And you say this is anamorphic on a budget? Blah, 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 blah.
In my defense, I just talked about the series that costs $700. So I do cover budget options. Now, putting things in perspective, the usual cine anamorphic lens still costs 30 grand. An anamorphic that covers full frame, though, can cost more than that. Atlas sits at 8K, but you'll need an expander to cover full frame and deal with light loss and those other issues. It's still budget, although not cheap. Sharpness, we can see lots of chromatic aberration when wide open. We see some magenta and green. Center sharpness is pretty good, and both center and edges improve greatly when stopped down. The flares are strong, purple and teal. Watching Duclos' quick look, he got vertical red streaks on flares, which didn't show up in any of my tests, and I've been trying. I don't know what to make of this, but I thought you should know. Bokeh is smooth thanks to the circular aperture. 1.8 times is strong enough to create noticeable ovals. The longer focal length helps keeping distortion under control. The Vazen 85 shows a bit of bulging in the center and slight barrel distortion on the edges. Very subtle and very easy to correct if needed. Breathing is noticeable as you focus. The image contracts and expands as you go from infinity to close focus and back. Coverage is a topic that I can't properly cover here. I cap sensor size at full frame, but the Vazen 85 covers much more. According to New York DP Michael Della Pola, it covers the entire sensor of the Fuji GFX100, which is 43.8 by 32.9 millimeters, which is a whole new tier of sensor coverage. You can get started on your medium format anamorphic journey by picking up a Vazen 85mm. A lot of the footage in this video was shot on the S5 6K photo mode using a sensor crop that is taller than regular full frame video. The Vazen 85 uses the same focusing style as their 28mm. It is a different focusing mechanism from the one used in Siri, so you don't have squeeze changes through the focus range. It's also different from the Vazen 40, along with DIY setups and their variable strength diopters. That leaves you thinking about Panavision's focusing style, but that's not the one either. I'm still learning more so I can properly explain how Vazen focuses on a future video, so stay tuned. This is the perfect moment to hit that subscribe button. I still have a bit of a quarrel with Vazen's visual style. The orange collar and typography could be more fine-tuned. The logo on the lens cap is different from the logo on the side of the lens, and there are many fonts, way too many fonts used here. Oh, one last thought, the lens cap is a bit of a bubble, which makes the lens pretty unstable when sitting on the cap. I don't really love that, and I think a flat lens cap would land much better. What do you think of this lens? Let me know in the comments below if you have any suggestions for them. There is not a ton of content out there with it yet, so I look forward to seeing more. I'm glad to see Vazen's continued effort to expand and reach into new markets with their products. Thank you for hanging out. I hope you learned something new here today, and I'll see you next week. Tjitterbehandlings out.